Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Grill Nation Show with Jason Grill. Thanks for joining us today on the radio on KMBZ 980 AM, on podcast networks, on grillnationshow.com, and on our live stream here on my social media. You can check out all of our shows on my YouTube as well. Just search for Grill Nation Show on YouTube with Jason Grill. Very excited about today's show. We are joined by Jasmine Nastasi and Amber Bodler from Stellar Image Studios, SIS. Their website is stellarimagestudios.org. Welcome to the show, everybody. How are you?
We are good. Doing
There's so
great.
Much to talk about on the show today. I just wanted to make sure that I didn't do too much of the logistics at the beginning with, you know, websites to go to and how do you find us. We can do that later, but let's get started with you all. First off, tell us about Stellar Image Studios, the website again, stellarimagestudios.org. Talk about that. Why don't we start with Amber?
Yeah, so we are a female-owned video production company in Brookside. My sister and I, right here, co-own it, and we've been in operations for about 3 years.
Yeah, you guys do a really good job. Your name is everywhere in Kansas City. You obviously are sisters. Tell us about that, Amber. We've never had you on the show before. We've had Jasmine on. What's your background? I'd like to get some interesting stories too out of you about your sister and your relationship too. So tell us about your background and then kind of how you guys kind of got engaged in this.
Well, growing up, we were always kind of, our father is like a extreme athlete. He is an MMA fighter. So we kind of grew up in like a UFC gym. And he always loved to play this game with us, like a real life fear factor.
Okay.
So he had us doing crazy things ever since we were young. We had like a high tolerance of risk just from simply
you
playing
did.
That game.
I don't know about me.
Jasmine always won the mental challenges. So if it was drinking a raw egg or sitting in an ice bath for, I think it was like over 30 minutes, like we were competing against each other, who could sit in it the longest. And anything that had to do with mental, Jasmine always won. And anything physical, I won.
Okay.
So our dad had us like on this tall deck in our backyard. He had a jujitsu belt wrapped around our waist and had us walk along across this. My mom came out and was like, "What is going on?" Like,
I feel like you guys had a fun childhood. I did not expect that story to come out first thing.
Yeah, I actually wasn't either, but we went there.
I love it.
So that's how we were raised.
Yeah. So you guys have been best friends your whole life then, huh?
Yeah, we've always been really close. Amber, like growing up, I feel like has always hung out with me and my friends. So she's 4 years younger than me, but she's always been she would always just be with my friend group. So I remember like when she turned like, I don't know, like my friends always just thought she was our age when really she was 4 years younger. She has like, I would say she's pretty mature for her age.
I thought you guys were twins. So I mean,
yeah, everyone thinks that.
Until I watched your video on your website, stellarimagestudios.org, and Amber is much smaller in the end of that promo video than you were, Jasmine.
Yeah, that's very true.
You were very tall, and she was not at that time. Now I think you're both about the same height, maybe. I don't know. But
my awkward years.
Tell us about, your different roles at the organization. You obviously started your own business together. Very cool. You have a lot of dynamics, obviously, being sisters and running a very successful company. Tell us about what you both do there and the differences between you two.
Yeah. So I run the business side of things and Amber is head of our creative team. So we have 5 full-time employees on our staff and then 2 interns. So Amber really like spearheads like the chief of editor position, the director on set, and I do all the sales and the operation. So I think that's what makes us very successful is that we have both sides to the business, not just that creative side. And it's how we've been able to grow and scale as well these past 3 years.
Just going to remind her a little bit, talk into the mic.
Oh yeah. I'm supposed to hear me. You guys are professional. You sound great.
Okay, cool.
Amber, thank you for doing that. You go ahead. You wanted to say something?
Yeah. I was just going to say, cause I related to that story when we were young. And it's similar to this day of who we are. Like, she does the business side, a lot of mental things. And then I won the physical challenges, and I'm on operations, the hands-on type of comp, like onset, carrying gear. So it's kind of funny how we're so similar to like when we were kids to what we are now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's very funny. It's awesome though. Your personalities definitely come out. We're talking to the co-founders of Stellar Image Studios. Their website is stellarimagestudios.org. You guys have pillars for organization at SIS. I'm going to put them up on the screen right now. Mentorship, flexibility, equity, and integrity. Talk to us about those and why those are important to you.
Yeah, I would say mentorship is definitely a big pillar of Stellar Image Studios. And I would say, I have an amazing business mentor, and he's a 75-year-old man that I met when I was working at Catholic Charities, and he had owned two publishing companies, and he honestly volunteers his time to help me run the business, me and Amber run the business. And so I always say without him, SIS would not be here. So mentorship is a huge pillar of ours. I'm also a big and big brother's big sister. So I have, I'm a mentee and a mentor. Mm-hmm. So we also try to do that in our business as well. That's how show came about, mm-hmm. Is to mentor the next generation of video production professionals.
Yeah. We're going to talk about show. Amber, do you want to quickly talk about some of the other things that are part of your pillars?
Yeah. Flexibility is another one. And the reason why we put flexibility is because we want everyone to know that we put our clients first and we're very flexible with our schedule. We're not just sometimes 9 to 5. Sometimes we have to do a shoot that's.
Yeah. You're definitely not 9 to 5. I don't think anyone on that is. Most people that have been on this show aren't 9 to 5. We've done about 800 episodes, and I don't think, or 800 guests. And I would say that's a very small number.
Yeah. And on that same thread, we're really flexible with our team too, because mm-hmm. we're in a very creative field. So in order to fuel creatives, we have to be very flexible. And that's another big thing that we focus on flexibility.
Mm-hmm. Briefly go through the second two, or the last two, equity and integrity.
Yeah, so equity is important to us because we want everyone to have a seat at the table when it comes to video production. Mm-hmm. Video production is a very male dominated field, and we're really trying to change that through show, which we'll get more into. Mm-hmm. We're trying to minimize the gender gap in our industry. And so equity is a huge pillar of SIS. And then integrity, because we pride ourselves on doing the best work for our clients.
Yeah, I love it. I love it. StellarImageStudios.org. We're going to talk about show right after the break. That's what our topic is today. We're going to have many more guests on the show this week. I'm excited to learn more about show, what it means, what its impact's been, what are some of the results that have come out of it. It's one of Kansas City's, I think it's the only one of its kind in Kansas City in the video production community. We're also going to hear more from the sisters as well. You're listening to the Grill Nation Show. Thanks for joining us today. We'll be right back. Okay.
Awesome.
Your screen behind you guys.
No.
We're still rolling. And as soon as we go, we'll go to the next segment in a second, but we're still live, just so you know, on the internet.
Yeah.
Okay. So now we're going to bring in, we're going to have all, hold on a second. We're going to have you and we're going to bring Anastasia on. Jiu-jitsu. Okay.
Yep.
God.
You guys, yeah, that was your house probably was fun right off the bat.
Your house was fun to go to in the neighborhood, I'm sure.
It was always interesting.
I'll let Jasmine take this one.
Okay. Hold on a second. Let me share this. Okay. Everyone good? Anastasia, you can go off your mute now.
Okay, I will.
Okay. Okay. It's a longer segment, guys. 11:40, okay? And 3, 2, 1. Hello and welcome back to the Grill Nation show with Jason Grill. Thanks for joining us today on the radio, on podcast, on live stream, or on our website, grillnationshow.com. You can connect with me on social media all the time on Twitter at Jason Grill, and I'm on Facebook as well, on Instagram and on LinkedIn. Just search for at Jason Grill and the Grill Nation show. Again, today we are joined by the co-founders of Stellar Image Studios, Jasmine and Amber. Their website is stellarimagestudios.org. Also, now we are joined by Anastasia Caffrey with Avila University. Welcome to the show, Anastasia. How are
you? Thanks. I'm great. Thanks for having me.
It's great to have you. This has been a fun show already, but now we're going to kind of get to the nuts and bolts of what we're doing here, which is to talk about show. Let's start with Jasmine and Amber. Tell us what show is and how it came about.
Yeah, so SHOW is stands for CIS Hands-On Workshop, and it's a 9-week intensive curriculum to teach aspiring women and minorities how to do all the different aspects of video production from pre to post. We launched this program last year with only 3 participants. We did it in our 900 square foot studio, and we knew we wanted to expand it. And the big goal of this program is to really minimize the gender gap in our industry. Mm-hmm. And it's also a recruiting tool for us as we grow. And we've had a lot of success with it. One of the participants in the first cohort is now a full-time employee, which you'll hear from later. And I connected with Avila University. I think I connected with you all on LinkedIn initially.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. And I just reached out and kind of told them what we were doing and that we're looking for a partner. And Avila has been amazing. And they're going to allow us to host the second cohort at their space.
Wow. Very impressive. A cold LinkedIn intro led to this. Anastasia, tell us about that, and talk to us about why Avila University is interested in the SHOW program again, which stands for what again, Jasmine?
The CIS Hands-On Workshop.
CIS Hands-On Workshop. I've got it memorized. Anastasia, what are your thoughts about that?
Yeah, first of all, I want to say that it's been, such a pleasure working with Stellar Image Studios, because, these girls work so hard and they're very savvy, and we really want to support businesses like theirs. So I think we connected on LinkedIn. We found out we have other connections within the community too. One of our facilitators for our Workforce Development Academy at Avila also did kind of a cold introduction for us too, I think. And so we knew that we had great people in common and a great mission in common. So we've been really excited to do, we have a running list of things that we want to do with Stellar Image Studios because they're just so much fun to work with. So, mm-hmm.
And, is Avila, you're obviously allowing them to use some of your resources for this program.
Yeah, we are. So, the opportunity, kind of came up when, a couple opportunities when they needed some additional, computers and other kind of resources that we could offer them just kind of during the day for some of their employees. We're able to give some of that to them. And then with SHOW, this brings some really great people onto our campus and gives us an opportunity to, show them that, we're really living out our mission as a dear neighbor. We want to be a great partner with businesses like them. So, I really think that my favorite thing about what Jasmine and Amber are doing is that they're really focusing on people who might not have had an opportunity to get into this kind of a field. And that kind of goes along with a lot of the social justice things that the Sisters of Carondelet, the Sisters of St. Joseph of Carondelet kind of instilled in our university. Mm-hmm. And so when they approached us about this opportunity, we thought like, it's just kind of a no brainer. There's nobody else that I think could make that partnership so strong. So I'm super excited to see everybody on campus.
Yeah. And us having the workshop at Avila University will allow us to have 9 participants. So we're growing it from 3 participants to 9. Everyone's going to have their own Mac desktop. We'll have a like nice projector to use. Like we'll have a real classroom, because when we did it the first time, we made it work, but we had to transform our studio into a classroom. Yeah. So this is really allowing us to expand. So we're super excited and grateful for Avila University.
Mm. That's pretty cool. What's the program look like as far as the time and the dedication you need from the 9 people?
You want to take that?
Yeah. So it's sectioned off by weeks, and each week there's 2 days out of the week that you come, and it's about 3 hours each day. And the first week is Art of Storytelling. So you learn all about storyboarding, and you get a mock client that week too. And then the second week is basics of a camera. So you start to learn the ins and outs of camera operating. Third week is you kind of put those two together, your storyboard and your camera operating skills, into action, and you film your story for your client. And then the fourth week is Premiere Pro editing. Fifth week is After Effects editing. And then you have 2 weeks to edit your project fully, free form of just whenever. And then at the end, the last day of show is our graduation, where we have 3 judges sitting on a panel, and the teams will show their video, and they get unbiased feedback from live people. That was something I really wanted to incorporate, because that was one of the biggest takeaways I had going to art school, was group critiques. So I really wanted to incorporate that.
Yeah. So we'll have 3 judges from the community that is familiar with video production and is able to kind of critique and give them feedback on their project.
Mm. So what excites you most about this program? All of you, the question is to all of you, and the impact it's making. You've mentioned a lot that there's very little women in video production, or minorities for that matter. And why is that? What's the major impact? I mean, that's a lot of time, all those classes and all those workshops, especially when you're growing a company. Also a lot of spaces for Avila to dedicate to this. What really makes it so, this program so exciting to you, and the impact it's making so important?
Yeah, I think what excites me most is we've sent out the applications, and we've gotten some really, really creative and diverse people who've applied for the program. So I'm excited to just kind of dive into those applications and pick the 9 participants, because this is really like the next generation of video production professionals. We love to learn from other people, and we also like to teach. Like, we have a very collaborative environment. So I'm excited just to be more collaborative with more creators.
Yeah.
And I think the impact that it's having is we're minimizing the gender gap. Like, this is allowing, it's a small dent in it, but we're at least trying to do our part. Mm-hmm. We are there. The film commissioner told me that there was over 400 production companies in Kansas City, and we're one of the only 100% women owned video production companies. So that's kind of eye opening and a really big reason why we have this program.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Every year, what excites me the most is when we originally started this, the reason why we started is because I would get a lot of DMs from girls in my Instagram, just being like, hey, I have this video question. Can you answer this? And I used to be that person DMing people, asking video questions. So it felt full circle to really put this workshop together that I can truly dedicate time, that we can truly dedicate time to answer these questions. So every year, that's what excites me. And that I can teach as a woman to other women, because when I was DMing people, it was always males. So I'm excited that I can give them an opportunity to learn from a woman, because it's representation. It's just nice to see a woman in the field.
Mm-hmm. What about you from the Avila perspective, Anastasia?
Yeah, there, you know, there's so much excitement about this. I think the true impact for us is getting to see the snowball effect of women supporting women. And again, giving them that chance to get into an industry that they might not have had access to for a really long time. 400 companies in Kansas City. Yeah, let's support the ones that are savvy, that are women-owned, that are diverse, and that really care for our community and the success of the other women around us. So it's about community, and it's about doing the right thing. So I'm proud of you guys. It's a big impact. It is going to be, you know, there's 9 students, but that's still a huge impact. It's going to snowball, and next time we're going to expect 18.
Right? When does the cohort begin? When does the classes begin?
The week of January 12th.
Okay. So application, this is 2022. Okay.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Applications stop on December 1st though.
Yeah. So we're still accepting
applications. Very quickly. And so you said 9 people are going to get in.
Yep. Yeah.
Okay. That's a lot. From 3 to 9 is a lot.
I know. Throughout the year, we've had a lot of people reach out. I feel like since we've kind of been more, we've had more exposure, we've had video production professionals reach out to us and say that they want an internship or a job shadow. So this is also an opportunity for us to be like, sign up for show in the winter. Mm-hmm. And so I had a running list of people who had reached out to me, because I don't like to just not respond to people. And this was an opportunity for me to respond in a meaningful way. And I think I sent it over. I had a list of over 20 people who had said throughout the year that they were interested.
Wow.
So
that's awesome. Avila.edu, AVILA.edu. I want to thank Anastasia Caffrey for joining us to talk about kind of Avila's role in the show program.
Thank you for having me. This was fun.
Yeah. And keep us in the loop with Avila. And then obviously we're going to see how this next cohort goes, and hopefully it continues to grow, Anastasia. So thank you for joining us today.
Take care, guys.
Thank you. And we'll be right back on the Grill Nation show. Hey, okay.
Hey.
You guys do a great job. Let's bring in, is this all we're going to see with Jasmine then? Amber, are you the star of the show now?
She's the star of the show.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Well, now it's going to be.
Maybe Amber can join us for the very end, because we're going to be taping our sneak peek at the end.
Of me?
You're going to be on there with your sister at the end. Yes.
Oh, okay.
We'll let you know. You can go get some work done now, I guess.
Sweet. I'm going to change your name to Sierra and Amber. All right. I'll have Sierra come in.
Okay.
I'm just going to keep this off, by the way, because it keeps on going on.
Got it. Amber, how did I pronounce your last name?
You said Baudler, but it is Baudler.
Okay. We can edit that.
No, it's okay.
I thought it
Sometimes
was.
Sometimes I say Baudler.
I thought it was, but then I looked at my up at my screen to make sure, and I was like, so it's just Baudler.
Bowed.
Oh, like a bow, like a bow, like a bow.
Yep.
Got it.
This is Sierra. Put y'all headphones on. And Jasmine was talking like right here to it. It's
hi, Sierra.
Hello.
Okay. If I screw up your name again, Amber, you can call me out on it. okay. Sierra, I know how to pronounce your last name. It's easy. okay. We are going to start here in 3, 2, well, hold on a second. Whoops. Okay. In three, two, and one. Welcome back to the Grill Nation show with Jason Grill. Thanks for joining us today on KMBZ 980 AM on radio, on podcasts. We're on Apple, Google, all the different podcast networks, Spotify, Stitcher, you name it. Also on grillnationshow.com, where you can find all of our shows, links to our guests, all of their information, as well as also we're up on YouTube where you can watch all of our shows as well as listen to them. Again, we are joined today by Stellar Image Studios. Their website is stellarimagestudios.org. Put it up on the screen there so you can see it. We've lost Jasmine and Anastasia, but we've gained Sierra Cleaver.
Woo woo. Hello.
Amber, welcome back to the show as well from Stellar Image Studios. This is going to be a fun segment because we're going to talk about not only what Sierra went through with the show program, but also her background. So let's start there. Sierra, tell us about your background, about yourself. How'd you get interested in this career path? I noticed you went to Mizzou. I also went to law school at Mizzou. So I'm an alumnus like you. So that's cool.
Go Tigers.
Tell us about yourself.
Well, I'm born here in Kansas City, Missouri, and I got into video production, I would say, because of my grandma. So when I was young, we would have Christmases at her house, and she always had a video camera, like the old big ones, not the ones that we see today, like you have to put a tape in it and close it.
Yeah.
And I
had what I grew up on, Sierra. I'm old, so that's what I grew up on.
I kind of did for a little bit. But she would always record every time her granddaughters were over, and there's like literally six of us. She had four sons, and her four sons had all girls. So we loved being recorded on camera, and then we wanted to watch it afterwards. So I would say that's where my love for cameras started. And then as I got older, I met my best friend Lauren, and she had a digital camera. And we would always go on adventures and make little vlogs. We were like 12 years old, and then we would sit on Windows Movie Maker and like edit them and put them on Facebook. That was before YouTube was a thing. And then I started my own YouTube channel, got my own digital camera for Christmas when I was in middle school, and just started recording my own videos throughout my life. And it was just something that was really fun to me. And then as I got into high school, I went to Lee Summit West, and I had a great video production teacher. Her name is Carrie Smithia. She's awesome. I give a lot of credit to her for where I am to this day. And then I went to Mizzou and studied digital storytelling there. And then graduated, but I ended up going into the corporate world because I didn't even know that there was video production companies in Kansas City. So I always just thought like I had to move to like Los Angeles or like a bigger city. So I just started working in the corporate world for 2 years. And then I heard about Sis.
Man, you really did a great job with that rundown. I'll tell you what. Gosh.
Thank you.
I can tell why you're good at this stuff. Yeah. Tell us about how you got interested in show and kind of, what you learned throughout that process that kind of really excited you.
Yeah. So I happened to be at a friend's house, and Jasmine's best friend, Anissa, was there, and I was about to leave. And it was my first time meeting her, and she asked what I did. And I said, I work for this company, it's sales. I don't really like it. Like, my dream is to work in video or do YouTube. And she was like, no way. My best friend has a woman-owned video production company. I was like, are you serious? She was like, yes. So then we took down each other's information, and they said that they were like hiring. So I applied to work there. Didn't get the job at first, but they wanted me to come back to take this new program called Show. So at first I was like, I don't know, a little defeated, but I guess I'll try it out.
Well, and I don't think it's probably because of your skill set, because they're a growing company, right? I mean, you got a cinematography and film and video production college degree. I mean, that's pretty cool, I think.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Not like you were just reaching out on a DM like, hey, I like videos. Like, can I come and work here?
Yeah, you
had a degree in this.
Yeah, I had a degree, and also I've been doing YouTube for years, but I hadn't really been like in the professional world, I would say, like making video. Like I would just do like personal vlogs and like fun pranks and stuff of that sort. So I, that's what I would say I didn't really have that experience in.
Yeah.
So they asked me to come back for show, which is their first time doing it. And I started the program and just fell in love with it, learned so much. And it made me like more confident in myself, I would say.
Amber, why don't you comment on Sierra as a student in show and kind of going through the program?
I would say there's so many things because it's so, I always give out like a little test on the first day of camera operating, just be like, hey, let's see where you guys are at. And like, typically not a lot of the questions are right, but by the end, they're all right. Like they're getting the questions right. They know what they're doing inside the camera. But beyond that, just like the technical things, the thing that was like really impressive to Jasmine and I, which is why she's now on the SIS team, is because the way she interacts with other people. We are way more human. Like we want to be human before we're video people, mm-hmm. video editors, camera operators. And Sierra was the one to help out everyone else with their projects. She would go on their sets, help them with editing, anything it was. Sierra, even this one girl had a funny storyline where we had to like crack open a sparkling water and like break dance. And Sierra signed up. She's like, okay, me, I'll break dance.
Sierra, there's no doubt you have a great personality. You've been called outgoing and also funny and spunky. You're also a prankster, according to what you just said. What is the best prank you've ever played on someone?
I would say the best prank that I can think of that I've played on someone recently is probably the one that I did that's actually on my YouTube channel. So me and my boyfriend and his brother and his girlfriend, we decided that we were going to film like a couple's questions video. That's what we told the boys. But behind the scenes, me and the other girl were like, we're going to get into a fake fight in front of them because we've never fought before. Like we're always just friendly around each other just to see how they would react. So like we start the video and then at one point, like we just start catching attitudes, just throwing shade at each other. And then Madison storms off and my boyfriend's like, Sierra, calm down. Like, why are you getting so upset? Like stuff like that. But it was just hilarious because when we finally like, we're like, gotcha. Like there was like a sigh of relief and like the facial expressions that they were making were just really funny. But I would say that one was like a really good successful prank I got on camera. So
you don't meet many good pranksters anymore. This is quite an honor to have a prankster on the show.
I feel like we need to set up a prank to do on Jasmine sometime.
That'd be awesome.
Hilarious.
I'll be part of that one. What was your biggest takeaway from show, Sierra?
My biggest takeaway from show would probably be confidence, because I really lacked like self-confidence and I would always compare my work to other people's work, or I just didn't think I was as good as others or they're more advanced than me. But like I had to realize that everyone brings something different to the table. So it's like, oh, maybe I'm not the best at this, but I'm really great at this. And that could be the same for the other person too. And we always just like help each other out. So I would say being in show helped me gain a lot of confidence in my work and just in life in general.
Mm-hmm. What is your best advice for someone who's maybe thinking of going through this program and the show program with Jasmine and Amber and that you'd like to share?
My biggest advice would be a couple of things. Perseverance and never giving up, because for my background story, I didn't get the job first when I applied here, but then I took show and was able to show Jasmine and Amber my skill sets and how much I was dedicated and loved video production. And they saw that, and then they ended up offering me a job. And I was just really surprised. But so I would always just say, never give up. Don't compare yourself to other people. And just be confident within your work and know that you bring something special to the team.
Hmm. Well said. I think everyone should utilize that at some point too. They should always remember that advice, no matter what they do. And then again, Amber, tell us again what, and obviously Sierra, when you were going through the program, what was the couple really key nuggets that you learned that have really helped you in your career at SIS? And what are those key nuggets potentially? Is some more of the technical stuff. Is there something that, like, if you came out of that program, Sierra, that you could just share with the world that maybe you didn't know beforehand that really has enhanced your video production capabilities, that you learned during this weekly, during the weeks of this program that has really made you accelerate your career?
Yeah, a lot of things, actually. Before I took show, I didn't know certain camera settings at all. I would just play around with the exposure and everything and just be like, all right, this looks good. Hit and sit in front of the camera and start recording. And then I learned, like, no, there's specific settings that you should be filming in. I learned how to edit and organize my footage better, which makes me move faster. Just how to work a camera and just different, literally everything that you can think of within the video production you learn in this program, which is crazy because it's like 7 weeks, but you literally touch like everything. So I would definitely recommend people to apply, and it's just amazing. And like the friendships and relationships, like we feel like a family, even though like it was only 7 weeks. Like I was in week four and I was like, I don't want this to end. Like, this is like the best thing that's ever happened to me. So definitely just an amazing overall experience.
Amber Badler, would you, will you be featuring, or will Sierra have a role in the next class at any capacity?
Yes, she definitely will. She's like going to be doing a whole entire speech. She's going to be helping people with their projects. She's going to be very hands-on in this next show. And that's really the biggest piece of what show is. You can learn on YouTube, of course, like most of us have, but it's different when it's hands-on. It's different when you have the actual camera in your hand. So that's the biggest takeaway always for me, is just giving out the opportunity for people to have physical hands-on experience, and especially with a real client.
Well, that's awesome. I want to thank Sierra for joining us on this segment, Sierra Cleaver, and obviously Amber Badler from Stellar Image Studios. We'll be right back after the break with more of the Grill Nation Show. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Sierra.
You're welcome.
You're awesome.
Thank you. Thanks.
Fun. Yeah. Okay. Who's next up? Marissa?
Marissa.
I used to do this stuff too as a kid. I wanted to be a broadcast journalist, like a sports reporter. And I videotaped, like, I did like tape recordings of games and stuff, Amber, like where I'd call the game. At Christmas, obviously we had a tape recorder, a video recorder that we did all the videos like you guys did as kids.
That's so funny. It looks like Darren did too.
Yeah. Darren's a professional, man. He's got some stories. He's interviewed some pretty big people in the country music world and all over the place.
Yes.
Okay. Let's change your name on the video there.
Gotcha. Thank you. All right.
Okay. You ready to go, Marissa?
Yep. Ready.
Okay. Okay. In 3, 2, 1. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Grill Nation Show with Jason Grill. Hope you've enjoyed this show, however you're listening or watching. Always appreciate you following the show and joining us each and every week. Again, joined by Amber Badler from Stellar Image Studios. She's one of the co-founders and co-owners, along with her sister, Jasmine Nastasi. Their website is stellarimagestudios.org. Don't put .com, it's .org. And we're joined now by Marissa Grady, who is an intern at Stellar Image Studios and also will be going through the Sisters Hands-On Workshop, which is known as SHOW, at Avalon University coming up in January of 2022. Welcome to the show, Marissa. Tell us a little bit about yourself and how you got connected to Amber and Jasmine.
Yeah, happily. Thank you for having me on. I majored in theater. I've been a storyteller since I was a kid, just writing with my cousin and like just writing little songs or writing short stories and making silly videos that we would put on YouTube, embarrassingly enough. And then as I got older, went off to college, I realized that theater was what I wanted to do. I thought I wanted to be an actor. So I majored with a concentration in acting, wrote a thesis about it. And then senior year of college, I got my hands on a camera and said, oh no, I should have gone to film school. Turns out I love film. I love everything about video production. My family, when I was a kid, would just spend all of our free time watching movies. And so I just really have a love for the ability to tell stories specifically through video. And when I got married, I moved to Kansas City. My husband's in residency here at a hospital. And I wanted to move into video production. I had been working as a flight attendant when COVID happened. And then when COVID happened, I was like, yeah. So, and I knew a couple years into it that the lifestyle works for some people, but the lifestyle wasn't going to work for me long term. And I'd been trying to move into film since I had been working in that industry. So when I moved to Kansas City, I actually did cold message Jasmine on the Stellar Image website. I said, hi, I'm new to Kansas City. I have a small resume I'd love to send you with my own film projects that I have completed start to finish. And I would love to just get on your radar if you have any openings in the near future. And she said, actually, we do have an opening. Let's chat.
Where were you coming from, Amber? Or excuse me, Marissa?
I was coming from Dallas, Texas. I had been working in Chicago and then moved back to Dallas and then came back over here.
Oh, no. Jason looks like he got frozen.
We lost our internet there for a second. Let's start over there in 3, 2, 1. Marissa, tell us where you were coming from to Kansas City.
I was coming from Dallas, Texas, where I had grown up.
Okay. And you spent some time in Chicago as well?
I did. Yeah. I was based at O'Hare for a few years.
So Amber, I'm curious what you thought when you got a flight attendant reaching out to you to join the team. Something you never envisioned as someone applying at that point.
I'm open to everything, but actually what made me so interested in Marissa, I don't think I knew you were a flight attendant until you got onto the team, but on her portfolio that she had sent, there was also poetry, and I could just tell through her poems that she was such a good writer, and I write poetry too. And so I was like, this is super cool. Like, we should reach out. Her work was really good. So it was really more like her portfolio that she sent than the flight attendant. I don't even think I knew.
Yeah, it's not what I lead with usually.
Quite an experience though, traveling the world too, but also like the poetry stuff is pretty unique too. And that's obviously a point that we didn't get to talk to Amber about. Sounds like she's very into it as well and enjoys it. So that's a good connection for you to have. So you're going through this program now starting in January, and then hopefully we'll continue to grow your role with CIS following. What are you excited about and what are you looking forward to in the show program?
Oh gosh, just all of it. I am really looking forward to coming into my own more with a stronger ability to direct people, towing the line between confidence and kindness and having a clarity of vision. I feel like I can visualize what I want in a project, but I don't yet have the technical know-how for where the camera should sit, how far it should be from what we're filming. And I'm excited to practice those technical skills as well as learn how to direct a team, but also collaborate with new people that are going to be interesting and exciting to me.
I think it's interesting for you to talk about kind of when you had that epiphany where you decided to be behind the camera instead of in front of it. It's the same way in politics where I was in politics and you have someone that's elected, but then you have like more of the chief of staff role or the PR person. I mean, to me, it's interesting. And you see a lot of actors now directing as well. When they're very successful, they do both. Right. But what for you was that thing that made you decide like, okay, it's time to stop being in front of the camera, but go behind it. That's interesting to me.
Thank you for asking. I have always been a writer at heart. I do love different offshoots of the creative process. But if I was told you can never act again, I'd be like, okay, I can live with that. But if I was told you can never write again, that's where I would draw the line and be like, no, something has to change because this has to stay. So I knew that writing was the most integral thing to me in my life, in my soul. And also I knew, especially as a woman, that people, whenever I would direct films, because I would create films and I would also star in them, just because I was like, I'm just going to do everything. I don't know it. I don't know who to ask. I don't have the confidence to ask anybody to be part of this. But I would try to tell a story and people would say, oh, you look so sad. You should smile more. Like, why aren't you happy here? And it became more appearance focused, where with writing and with constructing the visuals of a film, I feel like I can influence what an audience takes away, including asking an audience look past the appearance of a person and into their heart. And that's mm-hmm. the kind of film that I want to make. And I feel like there's more power to do that with the writing and directing side of it. And then wow. stepping back into the acting if need be.
Yeah, I can't even believe you're an intern, Marissa. I mean, honestly, like, I feel like I'm talking to a veteran of the industry already. I mean, I feel like you're not, I feel like you're going to pass the show program. I'm not worried about you failing out of it.
Oh, good. Thank you.
You are wise. You are wise, 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 wise. Speaking of wise, Amber, we haven't asked you any personal questions yet, truthfully, since the first segment we were talking about your childhood. Do you have any best advice that you want to share with the listeners that has really propelled Sis in your career?
I got this from a book recently, and it's a book that many people read, but it's been sticking with me these past couple of months, is Have the End in Mind. And the reason for that is because it relates to just what you said of it's so good to know like what you want to accomplish in your mind, like the vision, but it's really hard to communicate that. So keeping the end in mind, having that in your head, you will always kind of know how to communicate throughout your project if you know what the end goal is. So that's why storyboarding is so important. It keeps us on sets very organized, and it's like a guide for us. So we're always super organized. So that's like been my main piece of advice. And it also just gets you started. If you ever want to do something, just go do it. Have that end in your mind and go do it. Go capture it. Go write it.
Well said. Marissa, since you're new to Kansas City, you don't have to answer this, but Amber, I do have a question about Kansas City. Since you guys are building an empire here, what is one thing that we do not have that you wish we had? And that can relate to your industry or that could relate to something in general. I always like to ask this question because it we have a lot of great things, but what is one thing you wish we had?
Well, I have something about the industry.
Okay.
A video. Right now, we don't have a lot of sources to rent. It's the best way to rent right now is through ShareGrid, and it's an app, and it's just other freelancers renting out their gear. So there's not one location like a shop like they have in LA, even Omaha, Nebraska. They have such good rental shops for cameras. But I mean, there's lights on, but they only have a selected few cameras. They don't have the cameras we shoot on. Mm-hmm. So that's the one thing I would say.
Very interesting. Marissa, we'll let you answer that question down the road when you've been here a little longer, right? You've been in all the big cities already. So I want to thank both of you for joining us. Obviously, I want to also thank Jasmine, Anastasia, and Sierra also for joining us. Again, stellarimagestudios.org is the website. I mean, just fascinating show. We could go on for hours with you guys. Hopefully, we'll have you on again to talk about kind of some of this deeper level stuff of video production and some of the things that you just talked about, best advice. Very interesting stuff. But check out the show program, which is starting again in January. The nominations and the applications are due December 1. We'll share that on our social media as well. But I want to thank Amber, Jasmine, Anastasia, Sierra, and Marissa for joining the show today. Thank you for listening to The Grill Nation Show. We'll see you again next week. Take care.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Great job, everyone.
Yay.
And now we're going to do our sneak peek with Amber and Jasmine. Marissa, it's nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you, too.
Yeah, you guys get me fired up.
I want to
take on a new hobby. But in our world, we're in the client service world, so it's a constant grind. Okay. Change your name again, unless you want to be Marissa. Welcome back, Jasmine.
Thank you.
Okay, this is a 2-minute and 15-second preview. And my question for you will be about show.
Okay.
What is it? Why'd you start it? And what has its impact been? And then you guys can both tackle that together. I want both people to speak here.
Okay.
Awesome. Okay.
I was going to say, you can say what it is and I can say how we started it.
Okay. Yep.
And then both of you can just chime in about the impact, what you're excited about. Cool?
Got it.
Okay. 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 Here we go. I'm going to bring myself up and then I'm going to pull you guys in. Hello, everybody, and welcome to this One Question Grill Nation Show sneak peek. I'm your host, Jason Grill. Thanks for joining us. On today's show, we have the two co-founders of Stellar Image Studios. Their website is stellarimagestudios.org. I'm joined by Jasmine Anastasi and Amber Badler. We are excited about the show this week. One question for you all as we get started today. We're going to be talking about the show program. First off, what is show? Why did you both start it? And what has its impact been? Let's start with Jasmine.
So show is the CIS hands-on workshop. It's a 9-week intensive curriculum for us to teach aspiring video professionals, specifically women and minorities, on the different aspects of video production. So we have 9 weeks where we teach everything from pre to post-production. Each team will get a mock client and they'll have the opportunity to tell or to film and edit their own video.
Mm-hmm. Amber, why'd you get started with it and what has its impact been?
So we got started by this with just our core value is mentorship at Stellar Image Studios. So we're like, how can we really make this true core value? And we came up with the idea to do a workshop, and we get so many DMs on a daily basis of women being like, how can I do this in Premiere Pro, this with my camera? So we decided to put it in like a full workshop so people could be really dedicated to the time. Mm-hmm. Because I can only give so many recommendations on YouTube links. I really need that one-on-one time. And this allows people to have that hands-on experience with the cameras and yep. with client interaction.
Yeah. And I think too, it's really made an impact because we are in a very male-dominated field and we're yep. really trying to minimize the gender gap in our industry.
And we will talk more about that. This show is action-packed. We're going to talk all about show this week on the Grill Nation Show with Stellar Image Studios. Thanks for watching this One Question sneak peek.
That was hard to answer in one question.
One second. Do you guys want to redo that?
No.
You good? Okay. Hold on one second, everybody.
Hold on. Don't ask Amber that.
Hold on.